All right. Hey, guys. Welcome back to Buffalo. Back in the GM chair here. We're going into the off season. I can't believe it, but as you can see, we won the cup. I can't freaking believe it. Still. But, you know, it's a nice surprise, and it tells me that we're way further ahead than I thought we were going to be. So, we won the cup. Tampa Bay won the Presidents. We went through them to win the cup. So, I guess they choked again. They have a history of that. The Canucks and us, yeah, we shouldn't... No shit. Mark Scheifele got the Art Ross. Mark Scheifele got the Hart. Shea Weber, the Norris. Kucherov, the Lady Bing. Kaapo Kakko got the Calder Memorial. All right. Conn Smythe, Jack Eichel, yeah. Vezina, Linus Ullmark. So we had a Vezina-winning goalie, too. He deserves to get paid, stick around. All right, Vasilevsky, you got the Jennings. Masterton, Jamie Oleksiak. All right, Jack Adams goes to the Sharks coach. Selke goes to Ryan O'Reilly. Mark Scheifele to Ted Lindsay. And Ovi to Maurice Richard. All right, that's cool. There are so many more. Okay, I don't care anymore. We didn't win anything. All right, did we get anything down here? Rochester. Nope. If you care, you can pause it. I stopped. All right. So, we have a lot of choices to make now. So, we just won the cup, which makes no sense. We've got a lot of our guys for the future here, in my opinion. I don't think we're moving on from a few of these. I even want to bring back Wayne Drain, even if he's a spare again. Because he was really useful. But we traded for Kubalik last time, and he proceeded to do this. So he's definitely been a good acquisition, to say the least. 22 points, 25 games in the playoffs. Eichel with 35 and 25. No wonder he won the Conn Smythe. All right. Skinner had almost a point a game as well. Same with Simmons. Played almost the whole run. All right. But then we have guys like Johansson and Cahoon that aren't really getting anywhere. But that's fine. But our biggest concern is going to be pretty much just coaching. So all of these guys are up this season. Every single one of them. I was planning on moving on from them. I'm actually going to have to put some more thought into that. Like, there might be a significant amount of time on my side between us re-signing, or us here at the draft, and us resigning. Because I'm not going to have you guys sit through all that. But I'm so torn on whether we're going to bring him back and bring back his assistants. Because they're all happy, but at the same time, he doesn't work with the guys coming up like Mittelstadt. So it's a tough choice. So it's either like Mittelstadt and our prospects go with the draft, or not at the draft, but like free agency. Or we, you know, get rid of our coach that just won us the cup. It's not really like a good choice here. It's a good problem because, you know, who cares? We won the championship. All right. Ooh, Minnesota gets the first overall. Ottawa from the Islanders at 2. Columbus at 3. Ottawa themselves at 4. And LA at 5. So Ottawa's going to have 2 top 5 picks. That's going to suck to deal with. I'm not so worried about it. That Ottawa pick is going to suck, though, having to play against them. All right, who retired? Hossa, Jokinen, Derek Roy, Drew Stafford. Interesting. I didn't know he was still in the game. Franzen, of course. Tom Gilbert, Matt Reed, Jason Garrison. Okay, goalies? No goalies, retired. All right. We did not have anyone retire. Okay. That's cool. Franzen and Jokinen are scouts, so they're going to continue existing in this world. I don't know what we're going to do with our picks. Because we don't have any but our own. So, I kind of want to just take it. Unless we can move up, find like a piece. Could go Edmonton. Yeah, I'm going to see what Edmonton would do. All right, do they want my first? I do want to move up. They don't. Okay. That's... No, I'm making a trade to make a trade. You know, we don't really need this pick. Well, we do, but we don't really need it to be that high. I think we'll be fine. All right, so who do we have here? We've got Gunler, Poirier. All right. No. No. A plus 9 points. Ooh, that's interesting. That I might want to grab. 64 points, almost a point a game. That's pretty good. I think I might go with that guy that had 9 points, though. What was his name? Jakimov? Yeah, Jakimov's. We're going to go with him. So, what do we get? All right, so Lafreniere went first. Millman second. Dadonov third. Ponomara fourth. Leach, Raymond, Holtz. Byfield and Perfetti at 8 and 9. That's a little low, but Lundell at 10. Stranges, Rossi, Kubernick, Wallander. Stutzel goes to the Flyers. All right. 10. Nice pick there by the Blues. We got a 64 top 6. That's all right. Hopefully, like, grows into something. But, oh well. Here we are at the guessing game. Let's see, is there anything, like, jumping out at me? I mean, this is the point where you're kind of pretty low in the draft. You know, finding someone with amazing potential is going to be hard to do. And nobody's jumping out at me here. I think I'm just going to let the computer pick. Winnipeg moved up. So that's cool. Travis Hamonic is now part of the LA Kings. There were a few pick movements. Wow, okay. Who needs a new contract as far as players go? I swear I saw Casey Mittelstadt there, which is going to suck. Because I don't know what I want to do here. They both need contracts, and I don't... Oh, wait, that's not Mittelstadt. This Reinhardt needs one. Does Mittelstadt need one? He does need one, too. Okay. He's an 82. Aw. Oh, he's going to be good. He's going to be real good, but he just doesn't fit our coach scheme. But at the same time, I don't know if I want to move on from the coach. It's tough. How much are you looking for? You're looking for 1.6 for 1 year. I think I might even be able to get away with you in the minors again. Sam Reinhardt deserves big money at this point. He kind of did a lot there. Especially moving over to center. Okay. So, I don't think we've got, like... I don't think this is going to be too bad. We have $30 million in cap space. I think we're going to be fine re-signing these guys. I'm going to get this done at least, and then we're going to decide on Mittelstadt as well as some other prospects and our coaches. So I'll see you guys in a bit. Alright, so we got our contracts done. We got our everything done. I decided we're going to keep the coach at least for now because we did win the cup. Why change things? So the only guys we still technically have to sign are Olofsson and Kubalik, but they're both qualified, and I'm probably going to just re-sign them as soon as the date changes just because they just don't want to take one right now. So I just throw an offer at them that they don't hate, and it should be fine. But Frolik is leaving. We have Wayne for 2 more years at 3 mil. I overpaid him a little. He didn't really want to stick around, actually. But I did want to make sure that he was there. So we also are going to need to grab 2 coaches, though. So I'm waiting to see on Mr. Johnson here, Ricky Johnson, and I was going to let go of Savard anyway, only because I don't want to have 2 forward coaches. We don't need that much help towards forwards. I'd rather have a generalist trying to boost everyone up, or something along that line. Maybe veterans, so that guys like Wayne don't fall off a cliff. But yeah, don't have any scouts. But yeah, so hopefully everything goes smooth, and we'll go into free agency. Okay. He's no longer going to be with us. We're going to need a new associate as well. Brought back Laxon and whatever. Yep. And who's in this free agent class? We have a little bit to spend, but not much. Taylor Hall. Ooh, the Blues were able to sign Petrie. Wow. Okay. So we've got Bertuzzi's not signed. That's interesting. I hope he stays not signed. All right, let's offer Kubalik, like, you know what? I'm gonna offer Kubalik that, and then we'll go to Olofsson. He wants less, so I'm going to bring him down to 4, and that will fit under the cap. I'm not so worried about the rest, because I don't want to overspend, especially if we have to sign Dahlin next season, which we do have to. But those are our 2 RFAs. I could try and move on from a guy like Marcus Johansson and see if anyone will bite. You know, go to a fine trade. How much is he making? I think 4.5. Yeah, 4.5 for another year. We could use this money and sign 1 year for a defenseman instead. And I think I'd rather do that because Johansson isn't really too quintessential here. So, yeah, we're going to do that. Right, I got to sign Jimmy Vesey, too. Right, okay. So, you know what? I'm going to see if I can move. No, you know what? We're going to keep Jake McCabe. I'm going to see if we can move Johansson, though. 2 seconds. Picks. Ooh. Medium starter goalie. Oh, we have a goalie. That's right. Afanasyev in a third. Yulevian in a sixth. That might be the one I take. That might legitimately just be the one I take. Ooh, first from Winnipeg. Oh, I'm torn there. He's going to the West. Stanley, Green, Nikkanen? Oh. You know what? I'm going to take a look at Yulevi. I'm going to see where he's sitting as far as overall. Hopefully he's not too bad. Okay. So, what are his stats like? He's not putting up too many points in Utica. He didn't take that many shots, so he wasn't going to score. His giveaway takeaways, okay, he's blocking a bunch, but... You know what? No, I don't think we want Oli Yulevi? We don't want him. We don't want him. I can tell you that for certain. Johansson, search again. I do just want to take the first. But, yeah, you know what? I'm going to just take the first. And Johansson is off, and we're going to make sure VC resigns. His chemistry there on the third line was actually solid. Jimmy VC. Oh, and now he wants less. Cool. We can offer him less because he's an RFA somehow. So I'm going to offer him a little bit. We're going to see where that ends up. But, okay, let's see what kind of defenseman we got here. Someone on a 1 year, Chara, maybe. Mike Green. No. I don't want to sign anyone for more than 1 year. But I don't want... See, Char is probably going to drop. Where was he sitting last season? You know, yeah, he's a minus. He took quite a few shots, but... He hits and he blocks. We could grab a guy on a 2 year, trade him at the draft, or trade someone else at the draft if need be. You know, that might not be a bad option. You know what? I think we're going to actually try out like Brendan Dillon. Someone I can get a little cheaper. I'm going to see what he wants for 2 years. 2 years he wants 4.3. So we're going to be coming close to the cap here. Okay, I'm going to take a pause quick. I'm going to figure this out. We need another... We're going to grab another defenseman, though. Someone a little bit higher overall. We're going to actually look for a third-line winger. I do still want someone on a short-term. Do we have the picks to do this? Okay. You know what? I'm going to throw this at him and see what happens. But I don't think he's going to actually, like, take it. And I don't think the Islanders would let him walk for that. Alright. So, maybe someone... Trevor Lewis. That might not be a bad idea. Bring back Tyler Ennis, that might not be a bad idea either. You know what, I think I'm going to go with Mr. Game 7 here. Give him a... try and offer him a con... Eh, nobody... Nobody's offering to these guys. I'm going to give it a few days. Yeah, I'll do that. Okay. All you, Florida. Enjoy. Cool. I'm actually going to, like, offer things now. That was a pleasant surprise. Yeah, so I'm going to, like, legitimately offer this now. Could be that guy that brings back Pommenville, too. But, no. Let's take a gamble on Trevor Lewis. We'll see where this leads. A lot more space than I expected. Alright, so we got a few guys signed. I saw that. I know we got Kubalik and we got VZ Olofsson signed. Cool. We're back to where we were. Definitely back to where we were, at least. So, they want to trade us Henrik Zetterberg for a first. No. No. Woo! Mr. Game 7 likes us for the playoffs. Trevor Lewis signed. Okay, there's our fourth liner. Alright, I think this is coming together. Alright. Two first for... No. No. Arizona, no. I forgot about the coach. Oh, no. We still got some good guys here. Ooh, we do. Okay. Generalist. I want high teaching, yeah. Ooh. Yeah, just put you for a boatload of money. I'll definitely take you there. Assistant, do we have good teaching assistant? I do want to... Can we do something like this? Bartkowski, I kind of want you to be the assistant. I'm going to overpay you so you take it too. Hopefully. Good thing the budget doesn't matter for your coaches. Alright, offer contract. There we go. Here we are. Beginning of the season. Let's take a look at the lines. I want to see if anyone grew. Alright. So, Skinner's an 85 now instead of an 84. Kubalik's an 84. Olofsson's an 82, though. Alright, so... And we don't have Wayne here. Yeah, we gotta fit Wayne in. After last season, we gotta fit Wayne in. So I'm gonna go back to this. Something like that. Tage Thompson, do you fit anywhere? You don't. Okay, this is the point where we start thinking if we can actually like move some of these guys. Jimmy VZ has a plus. Okay, so we have some decisions to make, for sure. Yeah, we got a lot of decisions to make here. I'm gonna go and see what I can make out of our current players and roster. I'll be back in a few. Alright, so here's where we're sitting at the moment. We've got Kubalik, Eichel, and Cahoon on the first line, getting that plus three. I think that's what we ended the playoff run up. So I'm pretty sure this is close to what we had in the playoffs. And it was working great. So Kubalik, Eichel, Cahoon, Skinner, Reinhardt, and Olofsson. We've got Justin Williams, Dylan Cousins, and Casey Mittelstadt on this third line, somehow getting a plus one. And I'm okay with that. Justin Williams definitely bringing it up, though. Wayne Train down here on the fourth line with Trevor Lewis and Jimmy VC. Trevor Lewis can actually take faceoffs. He can. So I decided to put him here, and we've got Tage Thompson sitting here. And I'm gonna be honest, he's still not fitting, and honestly, I just don't have a place for him.
I think we're going to move Thompson. Maybe pick up either a pick or see just what we can get. But I think we're sending out Tage Thompson. We'll definitely entertain offers at the very least. Goligoski. Demers. No. A first from Boston. Firsts are not bad. Studnicka, no. Zaboral, no. Maybe, actually. First from Calgary. That wouldn't be too bad. Coughlin, no. Delandra. Alright. Anything that, like, jumps out at me? Montreal for St. Louis, a first and a third. Okay. Who do I think is going to be worse? The Flames or the Blues? So I'd rather not... You know what? You know what? I'm going to take the extra pick and I'm going to trade him to the Blues. So, Blues, enjoy your very nice center there. I'll take that pick. And we'll bring up Gergensons. Yeah. Roster moves. Gergensons, you can come up. You're going to be our spare. Edit lines. Okay, so back to this. We've got our defense here. We've got Pilot up with Ristolainen. We've got Joki Harju, Dahlin, Jake McCabe, and Colin Miller. So, with this, I didn't really want to move McCabe and Miller off the first. They do get that plus three. But so do these guys, and I'd rather have Pilot growing. Dahlin still doesn't fit on this first line. It would be a plus one all around, but I decided an 86 and an 84, and then a 91 and a 91 and an 83 might be a little better. And then these guys are still getting a plus on this bottom line. So this should work out fine. The problem is we have Brandon Montour, and I'm only going to hold on to him because of injuries. Because there's no reason for us to have him right now. But anyway, we've got our power play here. We've got a plus three down here with Wayne Train on it, too. So that's nice. No chemistry on the four-man. We got a plus one here on the second line penalty kill. As you see, we've got Eichel and Mittelstadt doing penalties. I want to see them become well-rounded players. And then on the three-man, we've got minus ones, but what can you do? Olmark actually ended up jumping to an 86 as well. So that's kind of cool. We've got Hutton here. We've also got Peterson and Luukkonen. So Ooga Booga's like ready to be the starter here. But we've got Peterson, who can still grow as a backup. And I wouldn't be opposed to playing. So that might not be a bad idea. Best lines here. Ooh, okay. We need one more winger down there. I'll get that all sorted out. But this is what we're looking at. And I have turned injuries down a little. So hopefully they're not too overwhelming this time. Because last time it was pretty bad. I'll see you guys in December when we've gotten a little bit of Simmons done.
Hi, everybody. Along with Ray Ferraro, I'm James Cebulski. Welcome to Upstate New York here in Buffalo. The Sabres have had this portion of the schedule circled for a while. They're home for a bit. Get some practice time in, too.
The first game of the homestand, though, James, is always important because what looks like a good thing on the schedule can go south in a hurry if you play poorly and everybody gets agitated.
Are you kidding me? I go to get like a banner animation or something, and we get nothing? We get friggin' nothing? Holy shit, man. Alright. So, we're in December now. We're 15-6-3. Eichel already has 41 points? I didn't even look at that. Oh, jeez. He's going to, like, tear the league apart. Holy crap. Holy crap. Okay. We started off a little slow, but we've definitely picked it up as of late. The Red Wings are in first in the division. They got 40 points. It's nice to see that their rebuild took so little time. Maybe I shouldn't have given them friggin' Zetterberg. We got the Leafs behind us. Then it's the Habs, the Lightning, Bruins. Yeah. Panthers are sitting way low there now that they've got Kyle Okposo. And the Senators below them. That's just unlucky. All right, the Metro. We've got Penguins, Devils, and Hurricanes at the top, with the Rangers and the Flyers not too far behind. It still looks like this is the stronger division right now, which is weird. I mean, I know in the actual NHL, the Metro's stacked stupid and don't go in it, but oh well. Oilers, Night Sharks, Canucks and Flames in, as well as the Hawks, Preds, and Blues. Okay. So, seems to be pretty standard, except for the Avalanche all the way at the bottom there, but after that one season, I mean, they can fall off a cliff real quick and then come back. Alright. Yeah, everything else kind of looks par for the course. Alright. So, how's everyone doing? We've got Kubalik. He's got 13 points on the first line. One goal. Oof. Alright, we got Eichel, who's God. We've got Cahoon, who's got 19 and 24. That's pretty good. Jeff Skinner's got 31. That's nice. Wow, 29 for Sam Reinhart and 18 for Olofsson. So our top six is still lighting the lamp like crazy. That's nice. That's nice. We can bring up Wayne Train if we need to as well. But that would definitely ruin the chemistry a bit. Actually, let me see how these guys are doing. Middlestat's got 13 points. That's fine. 9 for Cousins. And 10 for Justin Williams. That's fine. That's fine. And then this bottom line is a train wreck. Okay. So, this is the point where I think we put in Gergensons again. Instead of Lewis, and I really hope that this works, because I don't really want to change this up too much now that we're finally on some sort of streak. But oh well, this first line's kind of even on the defensive end of it, but they're playing a lot. You know what? They've got points too. I can't complain. Darlene's got 16 points leading our defense so far. Yeah. So I think we have to do that for sure. Because Yogi Haraju isn't doing much there. I think it might be time to split up McCabe and Miller. But yeah, we could do that again, but Risto's top two. He's staying here. Alright, and how's Olmark doing? 907, that's good. Cal Peterson's here at a 902, that's fine. I do have Hutton still on the roster, but I've been trying to field offers on him and just seeing what the AI will offer. I mean, I'm not too sad if he doesn't get a game played, but I'd much rather Peterson, especially since he can grow and be our backup of the future if Olmark, say, leaves when his contract's done in 3 years, or in the off chance that Ooga Booga isn't ready, we have Peterson. So I think we're doing fine here. I'm not too worried. Let me just see what we're doing, like, as a team, but I don't think there's anything I truly want to change. So we are fourth in the league, which is nice. There's a 7-point gap between us and the Wings / Hawks for the top of the league. Man, that's... I wish they were in the same division. That would be an awesome rivalry in this season. You know, have the top two teams fighting it out, hating each other the whole time. But, oh well. So, goals 4 per game. We're at 3.5. That's good for... That looks like 7th. You're tied for 5th, but 7th in the league. Goals against per game. I know we were kind of low. Yeah, we were 8th. That's not too bad at all. Ooh, a 30.5 power play. That's cool. That's going to come down. But if we can stay on top like that, that would be awesome. A 77, though, I'm not too impressed on the penalty kill. But we also had that issue last season, and it didn't stop us. Except for the fact that we took so many stupid penalties. So, you know what? I'm going to do my due diligence. I'm going to take a look at the penalty kill. But I don't really want to change much other than this. So... I will see you guys probably at the deadline. Oh, wow. Florida's reloading. They got 2 firsts, but they traded away Keith Yandel. And they got rid of Okposo already. Oh, my God, Florida, why did you trade for him? I don't get it. All right, this is one that's a little more notable. This one's actually going to affect us a little bit. So Jonas Brodin is going to Montreal. They got another defenseman. New Jersey, what are you doing there? Mackenzie Blackwood for a first... Who's their goalie? What's their plan? Okay. So they've got 60 points. They're not too far out. Okay, they're selling. That's fine. So, who's their goalie? I gotta see this. The trade makes no sense as a whole in my mind for them. I guess they have Corey Crawford. Never mind. That was a great trade at New Jersey. Yeah, it'll work out great. What the hell is this AI? All right, and we've got Jason Demers moving. All right, Michael Delzaster is on waivers. No, I'm not gonna claim him. We've got too many defensemen right now on the roster as is. So we're sitting 2nd in the division. The Maple Leafs are ahead of us. But I think they had more games. Or games played, I should say. Yeah, they've got 3 more games played than us. But we're 2nd in the division. That's fine. The Red Wings are falling off a bit. Lightning and Habs are there. I can see why they bought a defenseman. Sens caught up. Panthers are still kind of there. You know what? Everyone in this division is still kind of in it. This is tight. We're not part of that conversation too much, but everyone else is pretty tight. We've got the Rangers trying to catch up too. They've got 63. They're only 4 points back. Same with the Flyers. Devils are only 5, but they traded away their goalie, and I don't get it. Blue Jackets are super out, though. We got the Flames at the top, Oilers, Sharks, Canucks. We've got the Hawks, Blues, Preds, and Jets. Okay. Yeah, I don't think this is going to be changing much. The Wild, Avs, and Stars are kind of super out. And the Coyotes have a chance, but that's about it. Kings and the Knights, maybe, but the Ducks, no. All right. So, Eichel's already at 83 points. That's amazing. This is never going to get old. So, he's got 83 points already. He's even, though. So, that means we're letting in a bunch of goals. Yeah, if I had to take a guess, we're letting in a bunch of goals. All right. You know what? Ooh, I don't think that's going to work, though. I think we need to do like that. You know what? We're doing exactly this. We're doing exactly this. Justin Williams, you're going on the bottom line with Gergensen's and VC. We're going to have Mittelstadt here still. And Cousins is growing nicely, actually. That's going to be cool. Wayne Train, you're going to come back up. Cahoon, yeah, I'm not going to change much here. But we're going to definitely... You know what? Is there anything else I can even, like, change? I could do that, but, like... I could do that. You know what? We're going to ride this to the end because we're a little higher up, so I want to see how this does. But I definitely will go back if stuff hits the fan. But I don't see us really needing a piece. I think we're just primed to go still. Top pairs is letting in a bunch, but... Yeah, that's fine. 913 for Allmark, 904 for Peterson. Okay. Yeah, we definitely don't need Hutton. But I'll hold on to him just in case we have any injury scares. Do we need to change something here? I mean, Pilot's definitely not, like, the best choice. We could put McCabe back up here. We could, you know, we could go back to this. But I've been liking Risto on this first pair. So I'm going to blame it on Pilot, and we're going to put him lower in the lineup. So now we're just, ironing things out. I think it's time for us to just keep going. Kubalik is down. All right. So Olofsson, you're coming back up. Trevor Lewis, you're jumping in. And, you know, I'm just going to leave him there. Extras, I think we need 3-on-3. We need a person, right? Yeah. So, I'll slot in. Who's not playing on the 3-on-3? You know what? You know, let's put Wayne Train there. Can't hurt, right? Yeah, why not? I'm keeping Wayne Train on the first line. That's it. All right. Gilka Harju's down. So it's a good thing we held on to Brandon Montour. It's a good thing we have him signed so long, too. He can't really, like, leave. All right. So we've got a 3-3 to end the season. Okay. Now we're getting all the injuries. 3-3, we take 2 of the 3. We took the division, but we didn't take the conference. Okay. We're at the top, 108 points. That's a really good season from us. 99 from the Maple Leafs, 93 the Lightning, and the Habs at 89 made it too. The Wings dropped out, and the Bruins just barely missed. So, the Metro, we've got 110 for the Penguins, 99 for Caps. Flyers are 96, and so are the Hurricanes. They went on a tear. So, Rangers missed out. Devils, Jackets, and Islanders. In the Pacific, we've got the Flames, Oilers, Canucks, Sharks, and Coyotes. So, Coyotes caught up. In the Central, we've got the Blues at the top, Blackhawks, and the Jets. So, we don't get any, like, super fancy picks from them. Okay. Okay. That'll be fine. But, let's take a look. Jack Eichel had 108 points. So, that's pretty nice right there. You know, let's see where we stack up as a team first. We were third in the league. Calgary had the... Wow, Calgary. 119 points. Wow. Okay. So, they had 119 points. We're third with 108. Do we have any, like, stupid teams that made or didn't make the playoffs? Or is everything like makes everything makes sense this time? Okay. So, goals for per game. Let's see where we sit. We should be near the top. Yeah, we're second. That's nice. Goals against, we're seventh. That's pretty good. So, I see that power play is way higher. Yeah, second in the league. And the penalty kill, second in the league. So, I don't think I want to change a damn thing. So, Eichel, 108 points. Reinhardt, 92. Jeff Skinner, 90. So, we've got three guys over a point per game. And two, you know, that's two different lines there for points. That's nice. Jack Eichel had 40. He had 56 points? Or 56 goals? My God. He might actually have beaten Ovi. All right. So, Olofsson, 69 points. Nice. Cahoon, 63. Risto, 60 for a defenseman. That's pretty damn good. Mittelstadt, 20 goals. Yeah, it looks like everything kind of fell in place. Got some minuses here still, but hopefully that doesn't show its ugly face. 908 for Olmark, 904 for Peterson. That's fine. Let's see where they stack up in the whole league. So we have the top point getter, Connor. We can. Connor McDavid, 115. But Eichel does look like he has the goal lead, at least for who's here. Draisaitl, 108.2. Kucherov, 101. Laine, 97. All right. Yeah. I think Eichel got the. Yeah, Eichel got the rocket. Wow. A D-man took a face off. Took two face offs and one. Wow. That I'm more impressed than any other thing I've seen so far. Goalies, let's take a look. Dave Rittich. He's winning the Vezina. He's like. Carter Hart's got better stats, but he's got less wins. Tristan Jarry is the backup, I assume. I mean, let's see. I think Matt Murray was up here somewhere. Yeah, they played about the same amount of time. You know what? It's going to be one of these guys for the Vezina. I mean, Dell's not even. Dell, I wouldn't consider. I think it's going to be Carter Hart, though. It's either going to be him or, like, Big Save Dave. So, let's see which one it values more, stats or wins. Yeah, who are we playing? We are playing the Hurricanes? Oh, it's doing that stupid. Okay, so. To the NHL, if you're going to have playoffs with wild cards, at least keep, you know, but still separate it so heavily by division, why does crap like this happen in your terrible, terrible format? Please change it when Seattle comes. Please? I mean, this one looks fine. We got 5-3. But this is 4-4, and I'm playing the Hurricanes, and the Penguins are playing the Habs. I don't know. I don't get it. Let's check out the lines for the Carolina Hurricanes. So, they've got, oh my god. Taylor Hall, Sebastian Aho, and Andrei Svechnikov, who's grown pretty nicely here and doing 87. We got Teravainen and Nikas and Niederreiter on the second line. Fogle, Trocheck, and Dzingel. Brock McGinn. Brock McGinn, I think. Yeah, Brock McGinn. Jordan Staal and Jordan Martinook. Alright. So, I'm intimidated. You got Brady Shea, Dougie Hamilton, Jake Gardner, Hayden Fleury. Chris Kreider. Chris Kreider on D. Chris Kreider on D. Slavin's out. Oh, Chris Kreider on D. Okay. The AI. You win, AI. Thousand IQ, I guess. They got Mackenzie Blackwood and they got Peter Mrazek. So I don't think we're gonna. Yeah, he's listed as a backup. I think this is gonna be tough. We've got a good lineup, but that's solid. Let's get into game one. I'm praying for less overtimes this time. The last one was really long. All right, first period. Let's see. 1-0 us. Dominic Kubalik. Ooh, he's still paying off. Second period. 2-2. Jeff Skinner gets one, but Svechnikov and Niederreiter. They're going to be tough to stop. Come on, guys. We need one. There we go. Brandon Montour. Wow. Boy, I'm glad I put you in there. And Vinny Trocheck scores from the circle. Yeah, from the circle. All right. And as I say something about overtime, we get overtime. Good thing it's not an elimination. All right, power play. Come on, guys. Come on. Ugh. All right, wasted power play there. And Carolina, Taylor Hall. Oh, boy. Oh, what happened with that power play? No. That was like it. I think the difference was that, yeah, the difference was Wayne on D, so, you know what, I'm gonna mess with this, how, Pilot's not doing anything, I'm gonna put Kubalik here instead, he's been on fire. I'm gonna keep Dahlin on that first one, but Kubalik, you're gonna be there now. I don't know how I didn't have you there in the first place, but come on, guys. All right, Yoki Haraju's back. All right, Montour. Thinking just ducks M. Montour he got us a goal, and I can't say much else about that. And Colin Miller was a minus. So I'm thinking we actually sit Colin Miller. And we're gonna keep Brandon Montour there. Alright. Jekimovs, whatever. Not worried about them right now. Alright. Ooga Booga's down. Replace player. I think we have another one down there. Yeah, we do have another one down there. Alright. Next game. Let's go. We got a tweaked power play. I didn't have a problem with much else. They're going to be scoring, so. First period. All right. 1-0. Niederreiter in the last 3 seconds. Second period. Nino Niederreiter. 15-03. Okay. Jordan Martin. Oh, thank you, VC, for breaking that shutout. We're out shooting them so badly. They took another penalty and we get scored on. What? Okay. Wow. So, we handily lost. Now we've dropped both games at home. That's not good. All right, come on, guys. I don't even know what to change. Come on. I'm just going to sim this game. Game one. Or period one. What am I doing? Teravainen from the goal line. I'm not surprised. They got two shots. And they're still scoring on us. Second period. They've got 12 shots. Oh, my God. Guys. What the hell is wrong with you? Thank you, Eichel. It's your first point of the playoffs, I think. Come on, man. Yeah. That's right. I'm calling you out, Eichel. There we go. That's better. Okay, so it's all tied up now. 44 shots to 17. And Dougie. Dougie takes it, and we're down by 3 after taking 47 friggin' shots in a game. And 19, guys? Come the frick on. And Pilot's down, okay. So, I guess we're playing Miller. Alright, I don't even know what to change here. At this point, it's like... So, like, what's going on? This is doing nothing. This is doing absolutely jack-diddly-dick. Alright, Trevor Lewis, you're coming back, and we're beating the crap out of these guys. Come on. I'm just gonna intimidate them until they lose. That sounds like a good idea, right? I mean, I think it might work. Olsen. You know what? I'm rolling with this for forwards. I don't want to break up that top six because they're not the problem. Except for Kubelik going down, and that's more of a spread out the scoring kind of thing. He's like the only guy that friggin' buried any. Alright, you know what? There we go. That's what we're gonna do. And what's Allmark done? What are you doing? You ain't helping. Peterson, you get a start. I mean, how much worse can it be? Oh, wait, I gotta check that. Okay. I don't know if they're still playing, but I'll put Ooga Booga in. What? Okay, that's scary chemistry. Alright, Ooga Booga, go back in. You got this, bud. I don't know what he's been doing. Alright. Yeah, Allmark is setting this one. You know what? No, he's our starter. I gotta go with it. I can't be mad even though he can't hold it down. Alright. First period. Let's go. 1-0, Carolina. Who won, Carolina? Jimmy Vesey got one, but Chris Kreider playing D. Oh, he can score. Oh, we tied it up. I accidentally hit the wrong button. Let's see what happens. Overtime. I'm not even jumping in this. I'm mad as hell. Oh, we got it. Oh, we finally scored a power play goal. Victor Olofsson, thank you. Oh. About freaking time we got one. What the hell? Alright.
Game number five. I'm not changing a thing. That worked out. I'm not changing a thing. First period. 3-1 Buffalo. Kubalik, Keuchel, and Olofsson. Okay. Second period. Nothing. Third period. Come on, guys. 2-goal lead. We got this. We got this. Come on, just keep peppering them. Don't worry about that penalty. You got this. Come on. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, we got a series here. We're back in it. Come on. We're in game 6. We got this. Come on. One game at a time. One game at a time. You guys got this. Oh, we got Pilot back. You know what? I'm not going to change a single thing. Because it worked last game. All right. Game 6. Come on. You got this, guys. I believe. Wayne Simmons. First goal of the game. All right. First period. And it's going to be 2-1 Buffalo. Dominic Cahoon scores as well, but Dougie Hamilton puts one in for the Hurricanes. Second period. We got no goals. All right. Third period. Ooh, Jack Eichel on the power play. 3-1. All right. This is close. This is close. 4-1. All right. All right, middle step. I see you there. I don't know why you're on the point, but... All right. And we're going to game 7. Whew. Oh, I'm excited. I'm excited. I can't believe we climbed back. Come on, it's anyone's game here. Game 7. I'm gonna take another quick look. You know what? I should check as well. I don't know if Slavin's back. I don't know if Kreider's actually like playing as a forward yet. I don't want to mess with a single thing. I really don't. All right, injury report though. Let's see. Carolina. All right, he's playable. He's probably in. All right, game number 7. Okay, can't go back. First period. I'm going to let this play out. Power play, come on, guys. Only got 2 shots so far. 3, 4, 6. Ooh, we're getting a bunch. Power play. Nothing doing. 10 shots, 11, 12. Wow. Power play, Carolina. And we score shorthanded, Casey Mittelstadt. Oof. All right. Second period. Come on, guys. Come on. Power play. Okay, we kill it off. Let's see. Hold it down. Power play again. We gotta stop taking penalties, guys. Alright, second period, nothing happens. I'll take it. Third period. Whew, Skinner. And it's 2. Oh, but Taylor Hall doesn't want it to end. He makes it 1. Power play for Carolina. Power play for Buffalo. Nothing. Alright, 4. Oh, and Sebastian Aho from right in front of the net. Oh, we're going to overtime. Game 7. All right, I'll see you guys in there.
And Girard, that puck is loose, kept in by Ryan Graves. Slap shot, and that hit a body in front. Battle for, down goes Matt Nieto. Penalty coming up on the Buffalo Sabres. Shot, score! Sam Girard picked up the loose puck as everybody...
everybody's focus was on the near side, and he throws it home from an impossible angle for his second of the season. The Avs have the 1-0 lead.
I feel like an idiot. I thought I hit unpause when I had paused the recording for something. And I didn't. We sat through 4 overtime periods, and we got outshot and lost. I'm mad that I didn't actually get the footage of this. I'm really pissed, actually. But we ended up losing to Sebastian Aho, who just buried it. I could show you in the instant replay at the very least. I'll show you the game winner. So, a little turnover here. And it goes up to Hamilton, who throws it over to Teravainen, and Aho shoves it in the net. I'm mad we didn't get the end of it live, but it was a hell of a game. Anyway, we'll see you in the next season where we take the draft, go over some contracts. We got to get Darlene signed. I'm really upset that we didn't get another chance at that cup. But, oh well. I'll see you guys in the next season. Hope you're having a fantastic day.